Look at Pauline's face. This is amazing.
And is that your fella, Pauline? Is your son? Hello, son. What's your name? Is it Terry? Ricky. Why are you heckling him? We have other audience members heckling fucking Pauline. Leave her alone. She's from London, my neck of the woods. You take on Pauline, you take on me. Maybe not, you're a big fella. What's your name, son? Michael. How old are you, Michael? 37. Listen, son, man to man, there comes a time in your life when going out with your mum ain't cool. But if she's paying, you fucking take it, son. And who are you here with? Your mum? So you're here with your mum? Your mum's boyfriend? What? Hold on, we have a situation. Who the fuck are you here with? Who's that woman there? That's your uncle's girlfriend, and that bloke there is who? Your mum's boyfriend. Is Kerry Ann here this evening to deal with this? And how old are you, son? 15. Yeah. Hear that, son? Right. There's a young lad here, 15. He's not here with his mum, no. Not here with his dad, no. He is here with two fucking randoms. Sorted. 15. What year were you born? 1993. Did you hear that noise? That's called jealousy. There are people here in this room with underpants and socks older than you. You know who you are. What's your name, child? Robbie. Ah, is it still Robbie? One day, Robert, 15, I could be your dad. Well, obviously not. I'm a black man, and you're not. And this isn't prison. Who am I? Who am I? Who am I? Daddy. It's very good to be here in Australia, here in Sydney, that I'm at the moment, for this very lovely, lovely night. I've only been here a few days, and even I have noticed that your taxi drivers must clearly go to the International Taxi Driving School for fuckwits. Is that right? I'm just guessing, right? I got a taxi, right? And I said to him, oh, so-and-so street. And he did this, he went, what does that mean? So I also went, for 2 minutes it was this. I can't work with that. I got another taxi and I said, I want to go to the new town. And he went, the fare's too small. The fare is too small. Have you heard this ridiculous thing? Oh, you've always looked, yes, yes. This is no news to us. We hear it all the time. Of course it's too small. I said to him, if you found $5 in the street, would you stop and pick it up? And he went, yeah. And I said, this is the street. Here's $5, let's fucking do this. He had nothing to say. I know we've got some English people in the house. Where are the English folks again? Where are you from, you two? Kent? Don't know. Anybody else? Give me... One at a time, we're not barbarians. What was that? Leeds! Did you hear? Somebody booed what you said. How hilarious is that? I'm from Leeds! Boo! I'm not even on the same continent, but boo! Whoever booed, where are you from, the booing person?
Leeds!
he's proud. Leeds! I tell you, I'm from fucking Leeds! For those of you who don't know Leeds, which is kind of halfway up England, it's in the north of England, they talk like that. Hello! Hello! Can I be your friend? Oh my God, I swear to God, right? I drove up to Leeds, very, very strange. You young, how old are you, son, there? 17? Have you heard of Leeds in England? No? I was up there recently and I drove up there because I've got a car. Yeah. And there's a big sign on the motorway. It said Leeds, city full of surprises. I was there for 8 hours, nothing. Maybe that's the surprise. I get to the gig, in the front row, 12 stunning blonde ladies. They were quite clearly on some sort of hen do, because 11 of them were dressed as Indians. Feather in their hair. One of them was wearing a sari. Now, I'm not a member of Mensa, but I'm guessing she wasn't the sharpest tool in the box. Can you imagine her getting that phone call? Yeah, Sarah's do. We're all going as Indians. I'll see you there. Now, did you all get that joke? Child, did you get that joke? I'm looking at your face, there's fuck all there. I can see straight through your head. It's empty. Well, no, the wheel's turning, but the hamster's dead. At the same gig to my left, 4 guys, geezers. I went, all right, sir, what do you do for a living? He said, I'm a teacher. I said, is it a mixed school? He said, no, they're all white. I know. See, my face must have gone. Because he went, ah! And I do gigs all around the country. And I hear funny shit. I did a gig in London where I live. And it was in the East End of London where the Cockneys live. You know EastEnders? Yeah, that documentary, have you seen it? And it's full of geezers, men, real men, men who can barely read, but nonetheless, men. The sort of man that goes, all right, mate, how's your father? Fuck off, I don't know me father. What you looking at, you slag? That kind of person. I thought this is gonna be a tough crowd. What can I use as my opening line? So I tried this. I went, hi folks, is there anybody in from overseas? A little voice at the back went, yeah, mate, you! I didn't understand. At the end of the gig, the same young man comes right into my face and he goes, oi, mate, I never knew, I never fucking knew. Black people were funny. And I said, some of us ride bikes. Have been known to ski. Work with rudimentary tools. He didn't know what I meant.